years ago. I'm Bruce Baxter, one of the pastors here at Wesley, and I greet you in the name of the risen Christ. It's a great day to worship and to praise his holy name. If you're worshiping at Wesley for the first time, we are glad you've chosen today, and we hope you'll think about making Wesley your church home. And to help encourage you along, we've got a gift at the kiosk, various kiosks, a mug, or if you're a college student, we have a cup we'd love to send home with you to just remind you of the fellowship here in the presence of Christ. We have a few announcements today. You're going to get a vinyl pad coming by. We ask you to give us any contact information that you can that would be helpful. And in that vinyl pad is a giving brochure. If you missed last week we brought our giving estimates for next year forward. And if you missed last week, use that giving brochure. The last panel is a tear-off page. You can hand it to an usher, put it in the offering, or bring it to the altar and make your commitment for 2014 if you consider Wesley to be your church home. Today we've designated as Adoption Sunday. This is November's Adoption Month nationally across the country. And we celebrate at Wesley each year. We've designated today to celebrate adoptions in every way, both our spiritual adoption, each one of us adopted by God through Christ, and the ways in which families and individuals have been adopted or are adopted and have adopted. So we'll have that theme through the morning, and I think you'll enjoy seeing various aspects of the adoption here at Wesley. We as a church are going to adopt another church. And January 1st is going to be what we call Gotcha Day. And it's called the St. Paul United Methodist Church. They will close on December 31st, and we will adopt and have a second site down at the corner of Walnut and South Street. So I encourage you to be praying about that adoption and how God is working a miracle in that relationship. In fact, down at that location today, they're having a potluck at 12:30. So if you have a downtown inclination, you can head there after worship and be there for a potluck at 12:30 and meet a lot of the folks downtown. Today, out this door, you can celebrate a mission project, which is a scholarship that's funded for one of our future college students in the name of Donna James, a member here who died a few years ago of cancer. And her Sunday school class is putting this fair trade coffee, tea, and baked goods. So see them after service. They also have some sort of quilt or throw that they'd like to have you consider. Tonight, what are you doing tonight at 4 o'clock? Sunday night. I suggest maybe you come back here, and we're going to have this huge hanging of the greens party. We're going to decorate. It's going to look like Christmas after tonight, and Brian Batson and Fred Looper are going to get us all organized. The youth are going to go to the attic. Didn't even know we had an attic. We've got trees in the attic. They're going to do that this afternoon. So I invite you at 4 o'clock to come and just join the hanging of the greens. At 5 o'clock, we're going to have soup for everybody. And it'll just be fun. So I encourage you this afternoon when you're sitting around saying, what should we do? Let's go to Wesley and help decorate for Christmas. Now next Sunday is going to be the first Sunday of Advent. And our theme this year is the journey. We're going to follow with Mary and Joseph and Elizabeth from Nazareth to Bethlehem. And I encourage you to be preparing your hearts for that journey, the journey that you're on in your life. We're going to use some materials by Adam Hamilton, pastor in Kansas City. In fact, he has a devotional guide that's going to be available. If you or your family would like to have an Advent devotion guide, they'll be out at the Connection Counter next week. God is speaking to us today. God has gathered us here. He has a purpose for our being in this room during this hour. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you that there's power when your people gather to praise your name. For all the ways in which you have been preparing us through your word, through small groups, through Sunday school, through this week of our journey. And we pray that you would pour your spirit out upon us, that we might be open to your presence, and that we might be yielded to your will and purposes. Lord, we want to worship you in spirit and in truth. Pour your spirit out upon us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us stand as we worship. Oh,
Jesus.